It's not working. Just go.
Thank you.
Okay. I cannot hear anything good. Come to the front door. Come to the front door. Those are the people we're dealing with. They had like over a minute to get out. No. Why will you get out in that 1 minute? Instead, you'll be shouting there. Stop moving. They had children with you. literally sleeping. Like, come on. How come everyone else got off the bus? Everyone else got on the bus. And he's still inside the bus. Nowhere near the front door or the back door. And to top it off, getting upset. Because he pressed the button. Yeah, everyone else pressed the button and everyone else got out of the bus. So what's happening with you? The answer is you got no idea where you're going and you're not paying attention. Yeah, surprise, surprise. When you're on the bus, you have to pay attention as well. Because nobody's gonna come to your seat and tell you, excuse me, are you getting off at this bus stop? I believe this is your bus stop. No, nobody gives a fuck about you. So pay attention. And yeah, you are with two children. But you can still play a game with those two children. Like, tell them, okay, the first one to see the bus stop that we're getting off is the winner. So they're occupied, like it's three people. And those three people fail. Like, and then why the children are acting the way they are acting nowadays, with stabbing each other and swearing at the teachers and stealing and being unruly. Like, how can they not be? Well, this guy is a parent. This guy has two children. And he is clueless what he is doing. And yes, if you miss your bus stop, or if the doors close on you, go and speak with the driver. Don't be like that guy, staying on the back of the back door, on the back of the bus, pressing the button and getting upset. Like, a lot of people press that button when they are entering the bus. And they press it because even they don't know why. But they still press it. So how am I supposed to know that it's you and not them, and you want to get off? There's no way to know that. So getting upset, shouting, instead of just coming to the front of the bus and speak to the driver. Pure communication. Like, he failed to communicate his intentions to leave the bus. He failed to communicate to his children to look for the bus stop. Because, trust me, if you tell those two children to look for the bus stop and get ready as soon as the bus stop is near, they will be ready and they will see it. All you have to do is communicate, so he cannot even communicate with his own children, apparently. So. And the result is he cannot even communicate to that driver as well. So but he cannot communicate with anyone. Yes, when you are with children, it's more stressful to travel when you have children with you. And it's usually more stressful because of poor planning. So if you don't make proper plans, yeah, it's gonna be stressful when you're with children. As you can see, outside, close to freezing today, literally close to zero. And I have to make a choice between having a visibility on the windows and staying warm, which obviously the choice was very obvious, stay warm. Who cares about the visibility? Just chilling with no lights on. Okay, he got no lights, that's what the issue is. Maybe. Maybe yes, maybe not. I don't know. Oh, he got lights. Okay guys, today is Sunday. I will upload this video on Monday, literally tomorrow. I'll put it for upload now when I go home. So once again, thank you everyone. Thank you everyone for subscribing, for liking the videos, and being here. Oh dear, how are those daggers?